Hi, Lewis Bloom in our downtown Los Angeles studio. Yes, it's not the Wally Park studio in Glendora. This is my home in downtown LA, my loft, and trying to keep social distance. And we've been doing some Skype interviews with some drivers, trying to keep you updated, see what they're up to. And how about one of our rookie top fuel racers joining us from Long Island, New York, Justin Ashley. Hi, Justin. Thanks for taking the time.
Thank you for taking the time to have me. I appreciate you having me on. I hope you and everyone out there is healthy and safe and doing the best you can right now during the situation.
So what have you been up to? Staying home with the family? What's the day-to-day life like for Justin right now?
So the day-to-day life for my family and I is different than anything we've ever experienced before. Just like everyone else out there, it's up to us to just make the best out of the situation we have right now. And really taking this time to kind of step back and first and foremost, be grateful for all the things that we do have, but really try and focus on a long-term growth strategy for our real estate business and focus on continuing to grow the race team and build for our existing partners that we have. Over the course of time, this will pass. It's just going to take some time. So I want to make sure that when it does, we'll be fully ready and excited to hit the track again.
Well, speaking of being on the racetrack, you've been to 5 events. You keep winning rounds. You keep going rounds. I mean, your team is really starting to make some moves. You've made some better runs. The car's running quicker. How confident are you and Aaron Brooks and the rest of your team going forward later this year?
I'm super confident in our team. I knew that from the minute I sat behind the wheel that we were going to make this thing go fast. It was just going to take a few races. It's all part of the process. It was going to take some time. And the more races that have gone by, the more comfortable I felt in the car and continuing to learn and continuing to grow every race. And Aaron Brooks has just done such a phenomenal job for a team that's only run a handful of races to be able to go out there and run in the low 370s and now start to do it consistently. It's just a testament to Aaron Brooks and the attention to detail that he has and the great job that the whole team has done to put us in a position to win every time we're at the racetrack. So I feel great about our team. I feel great about our car. And every time we're out there racing, I know that we have ourselves an opportunity to win, and it's up to us to just stay in our own lane and do everything we can to take advantage of it.
Hey, Justin, I look at the numbers. You've been in 10 rounds of racing. You've only been left on once, and that was by Doug Coletta, one of the best in the business. How are you so good on that starting line in that Christmas tree? How does that happen?
Well, I just look at it like it's part of my job. I have to go up there and do the best job that I can every single time I get behind the wheel. And more so than anything else, it's important for me to just be robotic in my approach. So no matter who's in the other lane, no matter if it's a test session, if it's the first round of qualifying, or if it's the final round of eliminations, I look at everything the same. I just have to see the light and go and do it as quickly and as fast as I can. So my approach is just centered around doing everything the same every single time I get up there and have a chance to get behind the seat.
So who are some of the drivers that you've enjoyed racing so far? I know Antron Brown, a big part of your career. What was that like lining up against him?
Lining up against Antron Brown was really just a tremendous opportunity for me. I grew up watching Antron race, and that's a guy that I want to model my career after, but I also want to model my life after. He is just awesome at everything that he does. He represents his sponsors so well on the track and off the track, and he just does such a good job, and he's a great ambassador for the NHRA. So to be able to line up against him and race him was a privilege, and it really, for me, is something that it kind of just, it hits me in the heart, because growing up around him and around the sport, it just shows how quickly things can come full circle.
Didn't you make your top fuel license runs in Antron Brown's car a couple years ago in Norwalk, I believe?
Getting to license in Antron's car in 2017 was an incredible experience for me. And now here we are in 2020, and I was able to line up against him in a round of eliminations. When I was licensing in his car, I really didn't know what I didn't know. It was just an opportunity for me to try and grow and get better and figure out this whole top fuel thing. And now a few years later, here we are. And it's just come in one big full circle, and I feel fortunate to be a part of it.
Well, I'll never forget the fact that you got in Randy Meyer's car at Gainesville in 2017, your first national event, and you won the race. So you're used to success early. Might take a little bit longer with top fuel, but so far you've done a great job. I mean, you have to be thrilled with your progress so far.
Thank you. I appreciate it. I'm extraordinarily thrilled with our progress. As you said, in 2017, we were able to start off with a little bit of a spark with a win in my first ever race. And these things are hard to come by, so you never want to take any wins you get for granted. Just super happy with the progress that our Davis Motorsports team has made and the job Aaron Brooks has done with this car. And once this whole thing passes, God willing, everyone's going to be healthy and safe, and we'll get back out on the track soon, and I'm looking forward to it. I can't wait.
Hey, Justin, thanks for the time. Healthy and safe is the key words. Say hi to the family and take it easy out there in Long Island, and we'll see you at a race hopefully soon, and looking forward to watching your progress.
Will do. I appreciate it. Thank you for having me on.
Thanks to Justin Ashley for taking the time. More content here at NHRA.com, our social channels, NHRA.tv, YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. Stay safe. We'll see you soon. Thanks for watching.